lick this cream, thirsty in your dreams, tasting what this heart's about. Well,
if I was your lover, baby, I would never make you cry.
And my name's Charles. I'm a singer-songwriter from North London. I would say it's genreless. I try to, not genreless, genre blending. And yeah, just fun, really. It comes from the likes of Prince. Beyonce is a huge one as well, just for the sheer level of creativity that she brings to the table as an all-rounder. And then more recent, like Ne-Yo. So I kind of pull along from a lot. My dad used to listen to Luther Vandross and stuff like that when I was a kid, and then my mum would listen to Pink Floyd and Prince. So it was kind of like they were the two that kind of gelled my music brain together. I find that it's hard really, because I think when I was younger, there wasn't that many queer artists that were kind of out and were celebrated. I mean, what forced me to do what I do now is because I didn't actually see that much growing up. So that didn't really, I didn't have that much inspiration. I kind of thought that some people might be. Freddie Mercury obviously is a huge one. George Michael again. I think now looking back, I'm inspired by them more so now, knowing that they're queer, for sure. So I tend to write lyrics first, and that could be at any time, on the tube, at home, out and about. I don't write in lyric format, I just write how I feel. And then I get in the studio normally with my guitarist, Matthias, who's an amazing producer, and we sit down and we kind of build the song from start. So he'll start on the beats, I'll be behind. And then I start rearranging and rechecking the format of, and then trying to piece a song out of what I've written how I felt at the time. And yeah, and then we just get the juices flowing. Yeah, I reckon, yeah, there are some times when you look at each other and you're like, that is sick. And you just feel it, you know, you feel the music in your bones, it's underneath your skin. You're just like, this makes me want to move, or it makes you feel something, you know? So at the time when you create it, it's such a beautiful moment. And I always try and hold on to that feeling because I feel like that's it at its purest. By the end of the whole process of making a track, by the end of it, you've heard so much of it and you've picked it apart so much that you don't hear what you first heard, you know, and the feeling towards it suddenly becomes very oh, that doesn't sound right, or this doesn't sound right. So then you get the finished product at the end, and you're like, okay, this sounds good, and you're happy with it, but you've heard it 700 times, so, do you know what I mean? It doesn't quite have the same oh, I can't wait to listen to that in the morning. No. It's kind of always been he. I kind of made that choice a while ago. Try to be more if I'm going to do this and go into this, I want it to be quite open and honest that it's a guy that I like, you know? So Boyfriend's actually funny, you know? I wrote Boyfriend because I was a waiter at the time, and I was serving this group of girls, and they were one of them kept giving me the eye, and they were all very giggly, and I was this is funny, whatever. And then when they left, this girl wrote me a letter and put her number on it and passed it to me, and it was such an awkward transaction. And I was okay, thanks. And I was thinking, I don't want to embarrass her and being I'm actually gay, but I was okay, cool. And I wrote this song Boyfriend because I thought it was really interesting. The first verse of that song is about her perspective and where she feels that, how I imagined, you know, if she thought that I was going to be a boyfriend, what she kind of imagined this relationship to be. And, you know, and then the second verse, it kind of goes back to it's my perspective. It's we can get our nails done and we can do things like that. But, I'm not going to be a boyfriend. With Boyfriend, it's obviously a feature. it's like a collaboration with Brother Zulu. So we had Max from Brother Zulu down, and like we got him involved to sing his part, and he's insanely talented. Brother Zulu in general, like their music's just a funk dream. It's so good. I'm not actually the type of artist that would be like, my heart and everything is completely on my sleeve. I will be completely honest, but there will also still be parts of myself that I will wanna and have to keep to myself, just to like, I don't know, just to feel a bit more real about it, you know? Like, I think it'd be quite dangerous sometimes opening up so much and letting everyone in that you then don't remember who you are as a person. And not as Charles, you know? I love it, and I mean, don't get me wrong, like, I got it so wrong for so long when I was younger. Just trying out different things and being experimental with it, and I got it wrong many times to get it right. And now I feel like I'm sitting in a place with it where I can have fun with it and not take it too seriously, but like, it's like another extension of me. It's just got to be that it just gets better. And I think like every day, like it gets better. Like, and it might be like a small thing. And you can do huge things like today, like I'm at Abbey Road, you know, like out as like a proud gay black man. And I've been invited here to do this amazing thing. And like, there's constantly things like this that are happening in my career that like, are blowing my mind. Like my little self when I was 12 years old, and I felt so insecure and just unsettled by my queerness, and was so terrified of the word gay. Like I was like so terrified of it. And I think like it's amazing now to feel so comfortable and love a word that I used to absolutely despise, and getting to do stuff like this. Yeah, it's just like, it's just a bit crazy, really. I just tell him to keep going. You wanna lick this cream, thirsty in your dreams, tasting what this heart's about. Yeah, no, like, absolutely. I'm all about sort of teamwork makes dream work, you know what I mean? Like, and I wouldn't be where I am today if other artists that didn't help me. So, like, yeah, I'd love to. I think that's probably like one of the best things that you can do, and I think the best things you can experience as an artist, I think, is like helping bring up someone else that you just think is sick.